BDS India, People's Dispatch and NewsClick have together produced a report on military ties between India and Israel. Following extensive research, including tracking ongoing arms deals, this report contextualizes their scale, which is approximately $1 billion annually. In the growing paradigm of security collaboration and ideological symmetry between India and Israel. From a policy of unconditional support to the Palestinian freedom struggle to becoming an important ally of Israel's apartheid regime, India's changing stance on this issue is coterminous with its own journey towards fascism. Israel's military technology and methodology has perpetuated over seven decades of occupation, apartheid, and settler colonialism against Palestinian people. India's import of them is ominous. It threatens the right and liberties of ordinary citizens. It is a model of permanent insecurity and suspicion. The volume of this arms trade is detailed in annexes provided with the report. While not listing each and every deal, as the information about many of them is not available in the public domain, the report manages to give an estimate of the large scale of public money spent on importing Israeli weapons. It also shows their use and deployment. Israeli travel rifles, for example, are widely used by Indian parliamentary responsible for internal security in conflict zones such as Kashmir. The corruption of Israeli defense industry spills over to India, where the high-profile Barak missile deal was subject to a CVI inquiry. The Spike missiles deal has been cancelled and renegotiated multiple times, presumably under political pressure. An emerging trend is that of Israeli public and private defense companies entering into joint ventures with Indian companies. This includes a facility for producing the notorious Hermes drones developed during the 2014 Gaza massacre, for which Elbit Systems, Israel's largest private defense manufacturer, Adani Group, known to be close to the regime, have come together. India does not have a private defense industry per se, and though not alone, but this might mark the beginning of a private, profit-oriented defense sector. Under-training Indian police officers have been visiting Israel for what can only be a training in profiling, surveillance, and militarization of police. Indian Army has conducted several joint trainings with Israeli forces, including in Kashmir, where the ultra-right-wing central government has abrogated its special status. Israel-style illegal settlements in occupied West Bank would soon be copied here. It is already one of the most militarized zones in the world with flagrant human rights violations. Here, invocations of Israel's tactics by the Indian state are not just a foreboding but very real and everyday affair. India is putting electric fences on its international borders, the inspiration for which are the barriers that impose the seas on Gaza Strip. Israel's weapon industry develops and field tests its technologies on Palestinians during massacres. The revolving door between the occupation forces and the defense industry, and also the universities that produce war doctrines, make it a unified whole. This matrix enforces a perpetual insecurity where any manner of human rights are subservient to what is perceived as security, apart from profiteering from the illegal occupation. The import of weapons from Israel comes with this package. This model is not new for India, where in the last decades, persecution and even violence against Muslims, students, indigenous groups, and dissenters is becoming normalized. Israel adds on edge to this hyper-nationalism, evidenced in the recent hacking of cell phones of activists and lawyers with NSO groups Pegasus spyware. Given that this spyware is only sold to law enforcement agencies, the government has resorted to stonewalling any questions in this regard. India's purchase of Israeli weapons finances the occupation of Palestinians. More specifically, billions of dollars of Indian taxpayer money is spent on killing and maiming Palestinians. In turn, collaborations with Israel are intensifying militarism and securitization in India. It is normalizing spying of dissenters, perpetual suspicion of citizens, and use of disproportionate violence as long as it is for security. This is a downward spiral which can only be stopped by popular movements. The recent protests against India's new citizenship law have broken a long silence in the face of growing right-wing nationalism. The new citizenship law itself mirrors Israel's law of return. This is a moment for all of us to question the dangerous collaboration between India and Israel. We need to come in support of the Palestinian call for a military embargo on Israel and challenge growing militarism in India. Please read our report and send us your feedback. You can find a link to it in the description of this video.